Let's discuss another important concept in fluid statics, that is pressure at different levels in a liquid. When we talk about a static fluid, we can simply state a point. In a static fluid, it's a free surface is always normal to the effective acceleration acting on the fluid. Like for an example, we can simply state if we are having a container in which a liquid is filled. We can simply state the effective acceleration acting on it will be in downward direction, that is G. And the free surface of liquid will always exist in a direction normal to this G. And based on this, we can also state one more thing. All the points in the free surface must be at equal pressure, or we can say pressure at all these points must be equal as the fluid is in equilibrium. Or we can simply state all the layers of this fluid which are parallel to the free surface of liquid will also have equal pressure at all points in a layer. Like if we consider a point X, a point Y and a point Z here, we can simply state pressure at point X is equals to pressure at point Y is equals to pressure at point Z. So always remember that in a layer of fluid parallel to free surface of fluid, pressure remains same for all points. And it is not only for such a simple situation which I have taken, it is applicable for all kind of situation, like say we are given with a conical flask, and in which you can say we connect a tube, and the size of tube and shape of tube is varying like this, and through this tube a funnel is connected, and in the funnel we pour some liquid, and say liquid is filled up to this level in the tube as well as the conical flask is completely filled. In this situation, if I take a horizontal layer and there are three points in the liquid A, B and C which are on the same horizontal level, which is perpendicular to effective gravity acting on it, and we can simply state as all the three points are in a fluid body which is a single liquid, so we can always write PA is equals to PB is equals to PB. But equals to PC, but this is not the case when two or more liquids are mixed. Let us consider one more situation based on that. In sequence, let us discuss a situation when in a U-tube there are two immiscible liquids which are filled. This is a liquid of density rho 1, this is a liquid of density rho 2. And rho 1 is more than rho 2, because of which we can state as pressure due to the liquid 1 is more at the bottom, it has displaced the second liquid slightly upward. Now in this situation, say we consider few different points, like say there's a point A and there's a point B at the same level, and both A and B exist within the fluid body of liquid 1, we can write that pressure at point A must be equal to pressure at point B, because they lie on same horizontal layer which is normal to the effective gravity G. But if we consider a point C which is at the top of this liquid, and at the same level we consider a point D in the other liquid, although these are also at the same level, but still we can state that PC is not equal to PD as the two liquids are different and the points are lying on the same horizontal surface which is normal to G. still this will not be applicable because the two liquids are different. And this can be directly seen that as point C is at the top of this liquid, pressure at C can be taken as P atmospheric. Whereas if we talk about pressure at point D, it will be P atmospheric plus some value. So it will be more than P atmospheric. So we can directly state there is no direct correlation between pressure at C and pressure at D. So always remember, when we talk about a single liquid, we can always use pressure at all points in a layer which is normal to effective acceleration acting on it will remain constant.